The following program contains adult language, poor taste in jokes, racial slurs, political slurs, slants, and all sorts of things that if you are sensitive and have a delicate constitution, you should probably go watch Teletubbies. You were warned.
Hey kids, welcome back to Roto Talk.
Hey kids, welcome back. So, oh man, I am not ready for winter. I'm sorry. Up here in BFE, out where Jesus lost the sandals, Northern Indiana, it is cold, cold. Colder than my ex-wife, as I always say. But anyway, it's snowing right now. I looked at the forecast, and I was hoping we're going to at least have one 50-degree day in the next week or so I could paint this thing. And it does not look like that's going to happen. That's okay. Because I'd really love to get this thing in the water in the next few weeks. I mean, the build will be done this week. The videos will be finished and everything. But I can't throw it in the water until I paint it. So what we're going to do is we are going to, you guessed it, do some hardware. So got some leaves in here somehow. Bada bang. All right. So, we're going to do our strut today. The day kind of got away from me today. I was planning on doing the whole rear end, but we're just going to do the strut tonight. Because it's pretty late in the... Getting long in the tooth today. And I want to get this done. At least a little bit for you. So, this is the strut. This is the strut off the old Nintendo Cracker. The one that bit the dust a couple weeks ago. Sad. Such a cool boat. So sad. I got this from Joe at ZippKits. I buy the, depends on what I'm doing, but you can buy just the strut, or you can buy the strut with the basic hardware kit or the deluxe hardware kit, which comes with exhaust pipe and everything you need for the boat is the deluxe kit, I believe. So go to ZippKits.com. You can find that, or you can find it other places. So it is aluminum. It's very well made. It's a strut. You got a bushing in here, a brass bushing. And nothing too fancy about this. So this is off the old one. It is not brand new. So it's you can see that. So what we're going to do first now, follow the directions. He gives you, Joey, Uncle Joe at ZippKits, gives you directions on how to do the hardware, how to build this whole boat. So this is just how I do it. Again, that's what all these videos are, right? Obviously, it's how I do it. So what we're going to do... We're going to loosen this nut. Two-piece bracket. So this is what I call a double lock system. So you have a lock nut here. You know, got the neoprene in the middle. A lock nut and this side of the bracket's threaded. I like that. Because when I'm down at the water tuning, I don't necessarily tighten this. I'll tighten just the bolt. And then after I find my sweet spot, then I tighten the bolt and the nut to really lock it in place. So we're going to loosen this. Okay. Now, hopefully you guys can see this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to push this all the way up. Now, like I said, Joe in the directions, ZippKits for this boat, probably, definitely has where you, where he recommends you put this. I just do it my own way. Okay, so put this on a perfectly flat surface, and you'll see how the bracket lines up with the strut bar. Okay, it's nice and flush. And I make this all the way up, so as high as that strut would go. So if this is the boat, the prop's over here, shaft's coming in here, that would be the lowest it can go, that's the highest it can go. I make it the highest it can go, and I make sure this is all nice and flush. This is why, you know, going in your kitchen counter, wherever you can find a nice flat surface, and we're gonna torque this down. So these are nice and even, okay? There we go. So nice and even, that is as high as it can go, okay? Then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to guesstimate where this is going to go depth-wise, okay? So we know that this goes in about yay far, all right? This does not have to be perfect. But, so I'm going to mark it right about there. You want enough meat in this shaft that it's definitely going to go in there a long ways. Here's why. If you make it so the shaft only fits in this far, and then you go to, you need to kick your prop up a lot, the problem with that is that if you're only in there this far and you kick your angle up, you have the potential for this shaft to pop out. That would be bad, okay? We want that thing to always be seated. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna trim this with the Dremel. See how fast? Yep, there's that cutoff disc. Easy Lock, look those up on Amazon. Dremel Easy Lock, best thing in the world. So now what I'm gonna do is we're gonna file the inside a little bit. Now, another trick that I do sometimes, which will really make people cringe, is I will, where's my good one? Well, anyway, I have a fluted one of these. There it is. Step bit, okay? And I'll put that in there with the drill. You don't even have to use a drill, you can do it by hand. And that will cut the edge out of there perfect. Awesome. Then I take some 220 or whatever you got handy. It's not, here's 240. This is my wall of sandpaper, okay? And then I deburr by hand the outer edge. Nice, so that strut should slide on there nice and easy. Oh, look at that, pretty. So you can get an idea of how far this goes in. Perfect, that is plenty to go in, okay? Now, the other thing we're gonna do, you guys might have seen the video on annealing. I'm gonna flip this over, and I told you in that video of annealing that you want to anneal your shaft in two spots. Now remember, here's the part where we taped the hull so the epoxy wouldn't schmutz through, okay? And that turned out real good. We anneal it over here at the end where it comes out of the boat, and I anneal it here, okay? So we're just gonna mock this up. We're just gonna put this in like that, okay? That's all you need to do. Then I'm gonna take my trusty Sharpie and I'm going to anneal it here and probably here. Doesn't have to be perfect because this is just gonna, we're not gonna bend it. We're just going to anneal it. That way when we're down at the water and we're setting this thing up, we can go ahead and bend it when we tilt this. Okay, this isn't a stinger. Stingers go like this. This is more of a interpolated angle, as we would say in my line of work, okay? So what I'm gonna do, you can do this before you seal in your shaft, but I don't. So we're gonna angle this up a little bit, okay? Now, remember what I said in the annealing video, copper and brass dissipate heat exceptionally fast. So I'm gonna anneal this bit right here between the eyes, and it'll probably get hot to maybe here. We don't have to worry about it burning the boat or anything. So let me grab my torch, I'll be right back. All right, turned off the lights for a little mood, okay? Remember I said in the annealing video, if you turn off your lights, you'll be able to see the glow better. You can do it from both sides if you want. If you're one of those OCD dudes, try not to burn your arm off. Ow! Okay, done. That's all it takes. Now, see when I turn off lights, or turned on the lights, poof. You can't tell that was even glowing. So now what we're gonna do, we're not gonna bend it. That's it. That's all we're gonna do. And that's gonna cool off pretty quick. Now, the next thing we do is we measure from this end to this end and go in the middle and make a line. Now notice the center line of my bottom skins is not where I made this center line, okay? Because remember in the build video, I didn't mark this, the bottom skins. My center line of my bottom skins is actually off, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. But don't just, what I'm getting at is don't just take for granted that the seam of the middle skins is the middle. It's not. It might be this way, it might be this way. So I measured across here. You can measure across here. This is more accurate down the bottom. And this was exactly 15 inches. Exactly. So then, and we're gonna sand this. This is the only part of the boat I haven't sanded yet. So this is exactly 15 inches, so 7.5 is half. And there it is. Okay. So the next thing that we do is we take this dude. Now again, remember, we're at the lowest setting, or the highest setting of our strut. Again, this is just how I do it. We're gonna take that center line and we're going to mate it up right with the center of that strut. Right with that center part, okay? Just like that. Then, it's kind of a judgment call. You don't want to put it all the way down here, okay? Because if you put it all the way down there, that's as high as your prop will ever be able to be. That's not good. And if you put it all the way at the top, that wouldn't be smart, right? So use a little bit of judgment. I pretty much err on the side of center. That's it. It's nothing fancy. Because my prop's never going to need to be higher than that. Because you got to remember, that's the center line right there of your prop shaft. So that's going to, your prop's going to be out of the water for the most part. So I pretty much split the difference. It does, it's not that critical. It's more critical on a hydroplane. It's not that critical on a cracker box. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do, all right, and this is just me again. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to loosen this back up. I'm going to move it all the way. So that just gave us an idea. Where do we want to shoot? Pretty much the middle of the deck. Split the difference, okay? Now, I'm not really making sure it's as high as it'll go, but what I am doing, and you'll see why in a minute, loosen that bolt up, and I'm making that nice and level at the top. I'll show you why. Okay, tighten this up. All right, that's not right. Hang on. You'll see, you'll get it in a minute. There, nice and flush. Here's why, okay? What I'm gonna do is I am going to, we already know it's gotta be in the middle. So I'm gonna take a drill, and I'm gonna line this up. You can measure and be as geeky as you want. That's fine. A lot of people are, you know, make a little notch. Again, let the drill do the work, okay? Then what I'm gonna do is take my handy dandy electric screwdriver with an Allen bolt attachment, love this. If you work on boats a lot, the only thing these things are good for. I don't use them around the house at all. A lot of people use them as screwdrivers. I don't, I only use them for hardware on boats. Then I take a nut, or the bolt, okay? And I'm not going to put the shaft tube in because I don't care about that right now. Okay. Then what I do, I could have made that a little bit better. I might make that hole a touch bigger because I'm off center a touch. But that's okay. So what we're going to do now, I take a digital level. You don't have to use a digital level. You can use a normal torpedo bubble level. Level it here. And then level this and make sure it's kosher, okay? So I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn this on. My boat's about a degree off on the stand. I'm going to just zero it. Then I'm going to put it here. That's why I made this flush, so this thing can sit, okay? And then, ah, you bitch, all right. It depends how anal you want to be. Ah. Come on. All right. 0.8 of a degree will be okay. All right. So then I'm going to take my drill and I'm going to drill out the bottom left. I do not drill the other holes yet. I put the next bolt in. With that in, then I mark these two, or drill them all the way through. Helps if you have your bit out, because this hardware can stick out a bit. And that's it. Now I'm going to take it back out. Now, you don't have to have one of these stupid things. You can have just use it on a drill. No big thing. A lot faster with a drill, okay? All right. So, next thing we're going to do, we've already got this sanded and deburred on the inside. If you want to, at this point, not the worst idea, you could always take this line off. It doesn't really matter, but I'm going to slide this on. Now, the hardware that comes with the strut has lock nuts and washers and all that good stuff. I have lost those. That's all right. So I'm using my own set. I buy stainless hex sets off Amazon. And, oops, stand came off. All right. We're going to put all four. We're going to get them started. So far, so good. Okay. Now, whether you make it level this way or this way, as long as it's level, and honestly, it doesn't, it's not as critical as a rudder. So, not too bad. Looks good. Shaft tube's in. All right. The next thing that I do, turn that off, is I take, now, with the case of the hardware that comes with it, you don't need to do this because they have lock. Oh, that one's no good. Let me find some Loctite. Because when you have a lock nut, you don't necessarily have to use Loctite. So I put Loctite a little bit on there. And then I put my washers on. It's nice having this tiny little camera. These cameras are only GoPro Hero. It's only like 1.5 by 1.5. It's real easy to get everything in. Okay. And then I just get my nuts started. Now, the cracker is very, very easy to put hardware in, obviously. You're seeing this right now. It's like, hey, nothing but a peanut, man. Easy peasy. This is an easy boat. I've had boats that are way harder. Now, if you want, you can use a socket. Stick the socket on the back. But since we're using thread lock, I'm actually just going to do them. I'm going to hold the nut with my fingers, as she said. And it'll bind up by itself. It doesn't have to be deathly tight. The reason I like this No Cry brand off Amazon is it's an electric screwdriver with a clutch. So that's kind of nice. It can, you know, even if we do put a socket on there, or I don't have a socket on me, but let's just use a wrench. I'll grab hold that old nut. See? Now I shouldn't even have put thread lock on it because I have to take all this shit off, paint it. That's okay. I want to give you guys the full experience here. So a clutch is handy to have on these little junkers.
Okay, cool.
It's like $35. It's pretty good. And it's got a, you don't have to pull the battery out, you just plug it into a charger and it lasts like 6 years, the battery. All right, so that's about that. And then we can loosen up our nut, our bolt, sorry. Slide it up. Everything looks copacetic. Very nice. There's your strut. Shaft's in there. Notice I already bent it a touch. I did that on purpose when I bolted it in. And then if we need to, that would be a positive angle. Negative angle would be this way. Make the bow go down. We'll talk about that later in maybe a different video. But we're going to start off with this. You can see right here, it's coming out. We're going to start off with it at zero, which is going to be straight up and down. Well, no, we won't. I know from experience with the way I build crackers, maybe it's because of the foam I put in the front, I always have to have a positive angle. I believe the manual says set everything at zero and try it. But mine always have a positive 3 or 4 degrees, and they seem to work pretty good. So yeah, that's it. That is putting on the strut. As for the rudder, we're going to do that tomorrow. We're going to do rudder, turn fin, and tabs tomorrow. Just because it's getting late in the tooth tonight, and that's good enough. So we'll finish out the hardware tomorrow, maybe put in the cooling system, meaning the holes for the cooling lines and cooling outputs and inputs too. And then we'll be done with that bit, and then we'll move on to the radio box, and then this boat's about ready to float. And depending on my patience level, maybe we won't even paint it. Maybe we'll just clear coat it. Maybe we'll just brush on clear coat, seal the shit out of it, throw it in the lake anyway. I build a lot of crackers, man. I mean, it's not like, oh, this is my only chance to build this. I build 3 or 4 of these a year probably sometimes. So anyway, that's it. Keep the dry side up. As for the, you guys saw maybe the video, the boat club, you know, where we all get together and have that chat. That's going pretty good already. We got like 5 guys in there. We had a little bit of a chat today. It was kind of fun. So if you haven't already and you want to talk boats and just talk trash and have some fun, there's really no restrictions. You can do pretty much whatever you want. It's a good time. Email me at jjrotageek@gmail.com and I'll set you up. So until tomorrow, guys, keep dry side up. Bye.